Hi everyone. Today we take a look on the FEMA boiling point elevation. Or maybe you know it as the effect of dissolving. In short, it means that the steam pressure of a solution gets lower in comparison with the steam pressure of an unsolved substance. A further consequence is the increasing boiling point that is thematized in our task. The law of Raoul describes this with the following formula. Delta T is the ebullioscopic constant multiplied with the molality of the solution. In part A, they ask for this ebullioscopic constant. Or you can also call it the molal boiling point elevation constant. So first, let us illustrate what happens. We have 500 milliliters of benzene and pour 0.1 mole of our solute in the 500 milliliters of benzene. If we heat this mixture, we would see that it boils 0.58 degrees later, as if there was only benzene. But why does that happen? The solute causes a sink of the chemical potential. The benzene mixed with the solute needs more heat to change its phase because the solute interacts with the aromatic molecules and hold them in the liquid phase. Here we need 0.58 degrees more heat to change the phase of the solution. So we can now calculate our constant. At first, we should calculate the molality. It's the amount of molecules from the solute divided by the mass of the solvent. The solvent is benzene, and the amount of molecules are our 0.1 moles. And we don't know the mass of the benzene from the task, so we have to calculate it. And the mass is the density multiplied with the volume. So we can insert our numbers now. So 0.1 mole divided by the density, it's 0.876 gram per milliliter multiplied with 500 milliliter. And the result is 2.285 multiplied with 10 with a power of minus 4. This has the unit mole per gram, but this is not the SI unit. So we multiply this result with 1000 and we get 0.229 mole per kilogram. So now we can insert this in the formula of Raoul to calculate the ebullioscopic constant or molal boiling point elevation constant. So the difference of the temperatures is the new boiling temperature minus the normal boiling temperature of benzene divided by the molality 0.229 mole per kilogram. And because this is the difference, It's equal to Kelvin. So our result is 2.53 kilogram multiplied with Kelvin divided by mole. And because this fits to the literature value for the ebullioscopic constant of benzene, we can say that in general this should be the right solution. So now we take a look at part B. It says that 10 grams of a non-dissociating unknown is dissolved in 500 milliliters of benzene. The solution boils now at 80.97 degrees. What is the molar mass of the unknown? So we already calculated the ebullioscopic constant of benzene, so we can use it to calculate the molality of our solute in B. So here we have 0.87 degrees or Kelvin as difference and the constant with the unit Kelvin multiplied with kilogram divided by mole. And so our result for B is 0.34 mole per kilogram. And the question is, how much grams of the solute, the 10 grams, would be in 1 kilogram of benzene? So here we can see that in 1 kilogram of benzene would be 0.34 moles of the solute. And from the task we know that we have 10 grams of the unknown are in 500 milliliters of benzene. If we would multiply with the density of benzene, we know that 10 grams of the unknown correspond with 437.5 grams in benzene. So if we multiply with this factor, it's 2.28, we can see how many grams of the unknown would be in 1 kilogram of benzene. And yeah, this is the result. And with that result, we can calculate the molar mass. Because we standardize the value of 10 gram on the mass of 1 kilogram of benzene. And the molar mass is the mass of the unknown divided by the amount of molecules of the unknown. And this is the 22.8 grams divided by the 0.34 moles. And the result is 67 grams per mole. So this is the solution of the task. And with further methods, we could analyze what our unknown substance really is.